So, with Dragon Ball Heroes Episode 8 scheduled to be released sometime in February, we got brand new leaks from the Super Dragon Ball Heroes manga, which ties in with the Universal Conflict arc, showing us images from the upcoming manga chapter of Dragon Ball Heroes. Now, to start off this video, we have the first image here, and this image shows Kefla in her Super Saiyan form, and she looks all excited, ready to fight in battle. Now, we all kind of knew Kefla was going to be in Dragon Ball Heroes because she was shown in the opening fighting Zamasu of when the Universal Conflict arc started. Now, with this next image, we see Orin and Kamen, and they're basically surprised that Kale and Khalifa managed to fuse and says that it'll be interesting when they fight. Now, as we go to the next image, Kefla is indeed fighting Orin and Kamen, and it looks like she is holding her own against these two. Now, if you guys remembered in the previous episode, which was Dragon Ball Heroes Episode 7, Kale and Khalifa stood no chance against Orin and Kamen and were basically getting beaten by them. Hit and Kaba also stood no chance against them, as Orin and Kamen were completely destroying the strongest fighters of Universe 6. So when Kale and Khalifa does fuse, they will be much more stronger and might have a chance against Orin and Kamen. Now, if you guys remembered in the Tournament of Power, Kefla was able to beat a maxed out Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku and basically had to push Goku into Ultra Instinct. So this tells you that Kefla has an absurd amount of power within her, and I definitely can see her having a good fight with Orin and Kamen. Now, this next image definitely caught my eye when I saw this, and it's basically Kale and Khalifa once again, but this time they are defused, and it seems that they have the same markings as Orin and Kamen on their face. So this might have already confirmed the result between Kefla's fight with Orin and Kamen, which means Kefla loses the fight and will be controlled by Orin and Kamen. So this is definitely surprising to see, especially knowing that Kale and Khalifa are ridiculously powerful in their fused form, but still ends up losing the fight. Now, these markings on their face do resemble Baby from Dragon Ball GT, and what's really interesting about this is that Baby had the ability to control people and make them do evil acts in Dragon Ball GT. So this is probably the same thing Orin and Kamen are doing, as they very well might have the same abilities Baby had in Dragon Ball GT. So if Kale and Khalifa are very well being controlled by them, that means that they will join Orin and Kamen's group and will basically fight their own teammates, including Universe 7. Now, as we move on, we finally have clues of what might happen to Goku just before the prison planet exploded. In Dragon Ball Heroes Episode 6, everyone managed to escape the explosion of the prison planet, but in Goku's case, it looked like he was caught in the explosion and it seemed like he died from that. But with this new leaked image from the Heroes manga, the Grand Priest seems to be talking to somebody at Zeno's palace, and if you guys look very closely, you can see that the person the Grand Priest is speaking to resembles Goku, mainly because of the hair design, and it could be that the Grand Priest saved Goku right before the prison planet exploded. Now, this next image shows the Grand Priest speaking to whom, which looks like to be Goku, and what the Grand Priest is basically saying here is that the uniform that Goku is wearing suits him and also says that he's regained enough power. Now, after that, he says he has his own business to take care of and tells Goku he should return to his friends. So it seems that the Grand Priest has probably trained Goku or has given him more power to fight and save his friends and teammates from the evil warriors. If this is the case, then that means Goku will be the strongest he has ever been and possibly will surpass Mastered Ultra Instinct. Now, that is really crazy to hear, because it looks like Dragon Ball Heroes might be going in that direction. Now, it was confirmed in Dragon Ball Super that the Grand Priest is among the top 5 most powerful beings in the multiverse, and him training Goku will make Goku much more powerful, probably even surpassing his strongest form, which is Mastered Ultra Instinct. Now, as the Grand Priest is talking to Goku, Goku looks back and we have this image of Goku wearing the same clothes the Grand Priest wears, basically telling us that Goku has become an apprentice of the Grand Priest. If Goku very well has gained a significant amount of power from the Grand Priest, then Goku will most likely use this power to stop the six evil warriors from killing Zeno, because that is one of their main objectives. Now, do know that the angels as well as the Grand Priest are said to be the most powerful beings in the multiverse, so Goku receiving angelic powers from the Grand Priest will pretty much make Goku unstoppable at this point. Now, we do know that Zamasu, Cumber, and the rest of the individuals will come back much more powerful, which will make it extremely difficult for the heroes of Universe 6 and 7 to battle against. This is probably why the Grand Priest has given Goku this power to stop the six evil warriors from continuing with their plan. Now, moving on with the final two images, we have Beerus and Whis, and Beerus is basically wondering what happened to Goku. He wonders if Goku is dead, but Whis guesses he may have teleported somewhere beyond sensing at the last moment. So Beerus and Whis probably can't sense Goku right now because he is in a whole different world, and that is Zeno's palace. Now it's just a matter of time of when Goku will show up to save his friends, and I can already see that he'll be a big help in saving them. Now, that's all the leaked images we have from the upcoming chapter of the Dragon Ball Heroes manga, which will later show in the anime in the upcoming episodes. We all got to figure out that Goku is not dead and is indeed in Zeno's palace. So far, there has been no word of how Goku gets to Zeno's palace, but we all know that he managed to escape the explosion of the prison planet. The only two possible ways that Goku could have escaped is by either using instant transmission or getting saved by the Grand Priest. Now, by the time Goku leaves Zeno's palace and arrives to his friends, are Kale and Khalifa still gonna be controlled by the evil warriors? And if so, that would mean Goku would have to fight them both, since they are both being controlled. Eventually, Kale and Khalifa will probably stop being controlled by the evil warriors with the help of Goku there, because if Goku does manage to kill off the six individuals, I don't see him killing Kale and Khalifa since they were both already part of his team.